easy. And the Better Pasta Spoon. It not only measures your serving size, it stirs and separates for perfect pasta. You get the complete six-piece bonus pasta package free. Just pay shipping and handling. You get it all. The 8-quart Better Pasta Pot with the quick lock handles and two sets of holes. And the entire bonus pasta package. An incredible value, just $19.99. Call now.
To order the Better Pasta Pot, have your credit card ready and call 1-800-217-0422. That's 1-800-217-0422. Or send a check or money order to the address on your screen. So call 1-800-217-0422 and order today.
Storm Stories premieres January 6th on the Weather Channel. And now, here's your local on the 8th.
Currently, the temperature is 34 degrees, with rain and some freezing rain. Forecast. Extended forecast.
Good morning from Natick, Massachusetts. We're in the western Boston suburbs. I'm Mike Seidel, and we'll have more on the big snowstorm heading in here later today. All coming up on your weather today.
And of course, the central part of the country is already feeling the effects of snow. Roads like this interstate in St. Louis are covered in snow, providing a white Christmas but making travel difficult.
That big storm will have a big impact for your travel needs across the country, especially from Ohio to southern New England. We'll pinpoint the action for you coming up.
At the southern end of that storm, over the last couple of days, more than 30 tornadoes were reported all across the deep south. The threat of severe weather today is greatly diminished, but we could see some thunderstorms this morning in South Florida. Miami reported one just a short time ago.
Live from the Weather Channel, here's your weather today with Marshall Keith and Heather Tesh.
Good morning. Merry Christmas. It's half past the hour.
Now, some of the areas in the northeast could see as much as, get this, 20 inches of snow from this storm that's developing.
But right now, it is just rain in Washington, D.C., in Baltimore, but there is actually some sleet being reported now at Dulles Airport.
Cold conditions, too. And to your west in Pennsylvania, some freezing rain being reported in some locations. Had a little bit of snow in Chicago yesterday. That's pretty much over with, though. Most of the rain is relegated to South Florida and the Pacific Northwest. In between, just cold and clear conditions and wind chills a factor in the southeast. Let's take you first to that brewing storm in the northeast. Here's Heather.
Well, brewing to be quite a mess here across the northeast. And, you know, travel is going to get extremely treacherous as we head into the evening and overnight hours from Boston, traveling toward Hartford. We are continuing to find more snow here, too, working in across New York State. We have some of the snow continuing to press in here across Pennsylvania. And we're going to find some rainy conditions coming in here across the Mid-Atlantic, working into areas like Philadelphia. So we have some rain coming down in the Philadelphia area this morning. Now notice here around Pittsburgh, it's a rain-snow combo that we're seeing in this region. Cleveland picking up some snow. We also have some snow now in Pittsburgh, or I should say in Detroit, and we're also seeing snow in Indianapolis. Indianapolis, that's coming on top of about 5 or 6 inches you've already picked up. Another place that we're watching very closely is Boston. Now there's not a lot of action right now, but as we head through tonight, things are going to get extremely rough. We want to find out more about what's going to happen here and what is happening here with our Mike Seidel, who's standing by live just outside of the Boston region, west of the city. Mike, how's it looking right now?
It's just a cold, cloudy Wednesday morning here in the Boston suburbs. Temperatures running between about 28 and 30. Over at Logan now up to 34. And if you're near the coast or southeast towards Plymouth and out towards the Cape, you'll have less snow and more rain. But out here in the suburbs, we're expecting at least north and west of 495, a foot or more. Worcester up towards Fitchburg. Here in the Natick, Framingham area, around a foot of snow, if not more. And that will be combined with wind gusts in excess of 40, if not 50 miles an hour as you head towards the Boston shoreline. So very, very rough weather pattern setting up for later today through tonight. Right now, things are fine on Route 9 here at Natick, across from the beautiful Natick Mall. But that's going to change, and we'll have more and talk about what we expect to occur and when it all kicks in coming up in about 15 to 20 minutes here on the Weather Channel.
All right.
Back to you, Heather.
Thank you, Mike. And what we're going to find just through today is around Boston, probably 3 to 6 inches of snow. Again, a lot more snow coming in tonight in these areas. We're going to find in central and western Mass, as well as portions of New York into northwestern Pennsylvania, we could be looking at just today 6 to 12 inches, but some of these places are going to get near a couple of feet of snow by the time we work our way through tonight. New York City, rain today, but as we head toward the evening hours, even possibly late afternoon, look for some change over here, possibly 2 to 4 inches of snow in New York as we head through tonight. And in Philly, although it's going to be rain for today, maybe looking at a changeover as we head toward the evening. And here too, we could be looking at around an inch of snow coming down. Probably we'll mainly see rain around Washington, D.C., seeing a little bit of sleet right now at Dulles, and you could see a few more flakes as we continue to progress through today into tonight, but mainly it'll be rain. So very sloppy travel conditions, getting a lot worse as we head through tonight. You want to be very careful. Tomorrow, much improved conditions, though. Our system continues to pull out some morning leftover snow. Otherwise, quieter conditions, still windy, but once those roads get plowed, it will be much better to travel, and even a better day on Friday. Things really settle down. Marshall?
Now, you can blame that system for what you're going to feel outside today in the southeast and in Florida. Temperatures in the 30s, Atlanta and Birmingham, right near the freezing mark. Even snow fell in Atlanta, Georgia, some of the northern suburbs very early this morning. And the wind chill is a factor. These winds are going to be howling today. As that storm deepens to the north, the winds will increase to the south. Some of those winds could gust to better than 40 miles per hour around the Savannah River Valley today. And cold air will sweep southward toward Florida, too. Miami, you picked up a half an inch of rain just in the last hour and a half with this little system. It'll be moving off the coast. We'll be in pretty good shape later, but you could see an isolated thunderstorm later in the afternoon today. Front will clear the coast, though, and bring in the colder air beginning tomorrow. Look for a high of just 63 today in Orlando, 64 in Tampa. Rest of the south remain chilly, 50 degrees in Dallas, 41 in Tulsa. Now, tomorrow, temperatures will just be in the 40s in the southeast, but even worse than that in Florida, 57 degrees for a high in Orlando, 56 in Tampa, not getting above 60 on Friday, makes it for a very cold situation. It was cold in Champaign-Urbana yesterday. Here we had snow that fell, almost 4 inches of it, tied up traffic too on your last day of shopping before Christmas Day. Temperatures hovering right around the 20 to 30 degree mark this morning, so the snow's not going to melt very quickly. And even in Chicago, we picked up a little snow yesterday too, about an inch from O'Hare and a little bit more the further south you went and the further east that you go. We have a winter storm warning in effect for Detroit, where the snow continues to fall this morning and will continue to fall throughout the day today. Chicago, though, you'll go to mostly cloudy skies. 31 degrees will be your high. 37 in Kansas City and Omaha looks great with lots of sunshine. Same for tomorrow. Unfortunately, not a lot of snow here, so it was not a white Christmas throughout much of the Midwest. Heather?
Well, New England is expected to see some of the heaviest snowfall from the storm. We'll check back in with Mike Seidel from the Boston area in about 10 minutes. And while many people can't go anywhere when the roads are covered in snow and ice, we'll show you how this guy has no problems in the winter weather. Now, Dennis Smith is going to join us to talk about some more ordinary travel conditions.
That may be the popular mode of transportation in the Northeast and in Chicago.
Has that cold settled in your nose and throat?
It's awful.
Then let's erase these distractions and focus on your problem. That's what this new Alka-Seltzer Plus nose and throat does. It focuses on all these symptoms. Its concentrated medicine quickly dissolves and is ready to start working instantly, relieving your toughest nose and throat symptoms fast.
Thanks. I feel like myself again.
New Alka-Seltzer Plus nose and throat. And now Alka-Seltzer Plus is back in its classic seltzer flavor. Alka-Seltzer Plus harnesses the power to break up your cold.
One is fun, but two is funner. One's not bad, but two's my number. Together, life feels grand. Together with my best friend.
Where can you find browsing built for two? Introducing MSN 8, where advanced Microsoft software lets you link up with a friend and see the best of the web together. For browsing AOL can't match, it's better with the butterfly. Call 866-TRY-MSN-8.
A whole new internet service has landed. It's better with a...